teacher Joe from the Georgina Public Library, and welcome to Ready, Set, Kindergarten. And now, something we learn in kindergarten, and we practice pretty much every day for the rest of our lives, is lineup. Well, we're all staying in our homes to stay safe. We can't really practice lining up. But we can, because you can get some of your toys. Teacher Jo got a few of her toys, and I'll be the Yoda, because it's big and weird and wrinkly, just like Teacher Jo. Line up your toys. And I found a few things, and they see a lineup is like a train. It goes one after the other. Let's hope those Lego guys will stand up for us today. Now, you see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right after the other. You can practice with your stuffed toys. You can practice with the people in your house. You can take turns being at the front of the line, or in the middle of the line, or at the back of the line. But you see, everyone is got a little bit of space between them because we don't push and poke and shove people in the line. Think about lineups that you know. Trains are in the lineup. The drive-thru. Yeah, the drive-thru at McDonald's and Tim Hortons and all those places. The cars line up. So you can work on lining up and taking turns. And if you want to, you can walk and follow in your lineup. So we've done our lineup. And now I want everyone to sit down. All right. You guys can sit down too. Cross your legs if you can. And we're ready to say name songs. I made this really cool drum last week. I'm really excited about that. It's a piece of cardboard called a sonotube. You can use any kind of piece of cardboard or a tin can. Got some packaging tape, just plastic tape, and pulled it really tight. Leftover paint. We've got a really cool drum to sing our bumblebee song. So let's practice saying our names, singing our names, and we've got a little bit of tune music to go along. Ready? Hickledy pickledy bumblebee, can you say your name for me? What's your name? Sophie. Hi Sophie, how are you today? Well, that's good, glad to hear you are well. Hickledy pickledy bumblebee, can you sing your name for me? What's your name? Emma! I could drum that one. Emma. Two drums, two syllables. Hickledy pickledy bumblebee, can you sing your name for me? What's your name? Ian! Hi Ian. How are you? Good. One more. Hickledy pickledy bumblebee, can you sing your name for me? Evan. I'll drum that one. Evan. Good job. All right, so we'll put our drum aside. Now, we have a really special guest today. Now, because we're all practicing social distancing, and that means that we're staying in our own houses, I asked a friend of mine. She's a super friend of the library, too. Her name is Gail Johnston, and I asked her if she'd read you guys a story today. So, cozy up, sit down, listen to Gail's story, and then when her story's finished, get ready because we're going to learn about a really cool school activity.
Hi, my name's Gail, and Miss Jo asked me if I would read a book. So the book I chose is called I Love You. It's a Rubus poem. It's written by Jean Marzollo. It's illustrated by Suse McDonald, and it is a Scholastic book. I love you. Every bird loves a tree. Look at that. The mama's bird's on her nest with her babies, and they've done the wash. It's all hanging out. Every flower loves a bee. And you see how the bees are visiting? This bee is even bringing flowers to the flowers. That's funny. Every lock has a key. This lock wants the key to come see him. Open him up. He's a toy box full of lots and lots of adventures. And I love you. See the pinkies? Snuggling. Every sock loves a shoe. Oh, look at those polka dot heart shaped and stripes. Every ghost loves a boo. Boo. Everyone loves a two. And here they come on the train. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Woo-woo. And I love you. It's the mama with the baby koala bear. Up cuddling in a tree, feeling safe. Every shovel loves a pail. I love going to the beach, don't you, boys and girls? I love making sand castles and feeling the sand come up between my toes. Every monkey loves a tail. Why would they love a tail? So they can hang from trees. Every wave loves a whale. Look at it washing up over that whale. I bet that feels good to the whale too. And I love you. See the bunnies? Every farmer loves a rake. Look at the neat rows of veggies. Everybody will be in the garden soon. It's starting to warm up. And we'll get our plants out. Every duck loves a pond. Such fun. I love a pond too. I love splashing in the water, don't you? Every candle loves a cake. Yummy. And I love you. Another way to say I love you, boys and girls, is sign. And you go like this. I love you. Well, thank you for letting me read you a book. And maybe we'll see you again sometime.
Isn't that a great story? I like the way Gail showed the story and it had the pictures that you could read. I will post some more books like that on our kids program page on our website so that the adults at your house can find more Reba stories for you to help read along with if you'd like. And now, as promised, a super cool activity that you can do at home. First things first, we need to remind ourselves about colors. Red means stop or no. Green means yes or go. No, we're gonna play a little game first. So here we go. One of the things that lots of the teachers want the children to know when they get to school is how scissors work. And scissors are one of those things that adults go, ah, I don't want to give my kids scissors. So here we go. Let's learn about scissors. Are these scissors for children? Yes. Or no? Yes. For the green ones? No. For the red ones? You're right. No, not for children. One, they're very big. They're very sharp. And they will cut lots of things, including fingers. No, they're not for children. These scissors, are they for children? They're rounded on the end. They're not very big. And they're not terribly sharp. Yes or no? Yes, you're right. Green for go. Let's have a look at these ones. Now, these scissors are small. And they have the really cool thumb hole in the top. And remember, when you're cutting, make sure, grown-ups, that you make sure that the thumb goes up when you're cutting. We cut like this. Not on our side, not upside down, to get the best scissor movement. You have to learn that your thumb needs to face your chin. So, up and down, and your thumb is moving. Hope you can all see that. For kids? Yeah, you're right. Super giant metal scissors. Nope, you're right. Absolutely. Nope. Now, before you use scissors, you need to ask. Always ask the adult who's responsible for you if you can use scissors. Then you need to be sitting down, all right, so that you're safe. Scissors running around, not a cool plan. Then, what are we going to cut? We going to cut our clothes? Nope. Put the t-shirt on the right side. Are we going to cut paper? If an adult gives it to you, yes, you can cut the paper. Ah, but you say, Teacher Joe, books are made of paper. Are we going to cut books? You're right. We're not cutting books. This one is a tough one. Super cute rattly unicorn covered with hair and fuzz. Are we going to cut our toys? Absolutely not. Leave it the way it is. Are we going to cut hair? Save that to trained professionals. Absolutely. You don't cut your own hair, and you are not going to cut our brothers and sisters or cousins' hair or any of your friends, even if they say it's okay. But something that is super fun to cut, ask your family if you've got any straws. Grown-ups, this is a really good activity for people who are learning to cut, because sometimes the paper is hard to manage. But if you cut straws, one really fun thing is, lots of times, they go flying all over the place. And if you make a little pile of them after you collect them all up, you could get something like a pipe cleaner, a shoelace, a piece of string, some wool, and you can practice your lacing and threading by putting your straws on the string or the wire. So kind of super cool, lots of activity. Make sure you stay safe, you choose the right materials to cut with, and you gotta help the adults clean up. And that might be picking the straws up off the floor. All right, so what I'd like you to do is, if you're gonna do this at home, ask one of the adults to take your picture, maybe make a little video of your straws going flying like Teacher Joe's did, or just a nice photograph of you doing your cutting, and have someone post it to our Facebook page, or you can send us an email, and the email address is on our website, and we'll put your picture up of you doing your cutting. Ask the adults also, grown-ups, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. We want to get as many subscribers, especially during this time, so that you'll be the first to know what's happening at the library. I'm going to set that aside, bring back my super cool drum. Got to tell you about next week. Next week, on Thursday, when the Ready, Set, Kindergarten video comes out, our books are going to feature something rather funny. See, I went over to the library when I was in the library, I got a whole big pile of books. And then I got home and I was sorting the books out, and I realized there's a lot of books in there about underwear. So that's going to be our books about underwear for kids next week. Anyway, you ready? We're going to sing Head and Shoulders, Knees and Toes. I'll try and do a little drumming. It might not work, but we'll see what we can do. Are you ready? Our hands wave goodbye. Library time is over now. Our hands wave goodbye. Goodbye, Mason. Goodbye, Max. Goodbye, Ava. We'll see you here next week. Goodbye, Wyatt. Goodbye, Landon. Goodbye, everyone. We'll see you here next week.